Hello my dear students, welcome to CMIS online classes. In today's class, in this video, we will continue with chapter 3 of our English grammar, that is primary auxiliaries and modals. And in this video, we will specifically discuss about the uses of modal auxiliary verbs. Students, let's start today's discussion with the explanation of modal auxiliaries. You can see the list of modal auxiliaries here on the screen. They are can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would, ought to, must, have to, and used to. Besides these also, there are other modal auxiliaries also, but these modal auxiliaries are often we use in our daily sentences. In so many cases, like in direct and indirect speeches, we use could as the past tense of can, might as the past tense of past form of may, should as the past form of shall, and would as the past form of will. But these do not happen regularly. Understood? And ought to, must, have to, and used to are also the common modal auxiliaries that we use in our daily language. And these modal auxiliaries are mostly used to express ability of actions, probability of actions, seeking and granting permissions, restriction of actions, to offer something, making and taking suggestions, possibilities of actions, and etc. So now we will understand all these in detail one by one. Let us discuss with the use of can and could in sentences whenever we use them in expressing ability and inability. Ability means we are able to do something, and inability means we are not able to do something. So can and could help us to express something, that what we can do or what we cannot do. See, can is used to express ability in the present time or in future. So whenever we use can is used to express something which we can do in present and in future. Like I can climb mountains. That means my ability is here to climb mountains. As I have told you that modal auxiliaries are always used with main verb to give a meaningful sense. See here, climb is the main verb, and it has been used with the modal auxiliaries, a modal auxiliary can. So with the use of can here, the main verb action of climbing has been possible, and it has been an ability, expressed ability with the use of can. See, Sheila can't come to school tomorrow. See here, can't is the contraction form of can and not. Okay, can't. So here, can't means inability. That means unable to do something or unable to perform some action. See, whenever we express action that we can do in future, that will also be expressed by using can. Okay. Or by using will. I will not be able. See, can here has been used with be able. Can means be able. Okay, so here will has been used. Will is used to express future action. So here can has been used to express future action, be able. Can means to become able, and will has been used to express future. Can you see the big black rock in the distance? So here also it has been asked that am I able to see the big black rock in the distance or not. Now, could is the simple past form of can. It expresses ability in past. So, if something we were able to do in past, we cannot use can. But instead, we use could as the past form of can. Could you climb a mountain when you were young? That means it is the past. It tells us about the past moment. That means in past, that were I able to climb the mountain or not. In this case, if I have to express ability in the past time, then could is used as the past tense of can. I could say alphabet when I was 1.5 years old. That means it has been the moment of past. So here I am expressing my ability in past by the use of the modal auxiliary could as the past tense of can. See, we use be able to. Be able to also express our ability. Okay. In place of can and could, for these tenses we use can and could. So can and could. Can and could. Can. In present tense, can is used as is able, or could is used as past was able. Like see here, in present tense, can is changed to is able, and in past tense, could is used to as was able to. Okay, and in future it will become will be able. Will is used to express past action, so can and could. In future tense, can become will be able. Okay, all these express our ability and inability. Like, if I change this into negative, that inability, she is not able to. Okay, if it is the use of past tense in form of could, it becomes was not able to in negative. Okay, in inability. Okay, if I have to use this form of can in future as negative, will not be able or will be unable. Understood? Could can be also used in past tense if with the change of the subject. If the subject is plural, then it becomes were able, and if the subject is singular, it becomes was able. Can become is able, am able, I am able, okay, he is able, they are able. Okay, can is used is am are to express ability. Okay, in negative we have to add not after all these is am are to express ability, inability of the action. Now just forget about the use of could as the past tense of can. We can use either can also or could also in expressing or seeking and granting permission. If you want to, or if we want to ask for permission, or if we want to give permission, asking and giving permission, we can use either can or could or may also. Okay, see here, for example, could I use your color pencils? See, if I say, can I use your color pencils? May I use your color pencils? See, these all are, these all modal auxiliaries are together used for seeking permission. Okay. In the same way, we can also grant permission by using these modal auxiliaries. Okay, like, you can borrow my color pencils. You may borrow my color pencils. You could borrow my color pencils if you need them. So these three modal auxiliaries can be used in exchange of one another, instead of one another, to ask and give permission. So if we are not able to give permission, or there is some restriction, then also we can make the contraction form of can and not in negative to not give permission. Like, you can't borrow my color pencils. You may not borrow my color pencil. You could not borrow my color pencils. So here, not giving permission. Giving permission and not giving permission. So giving permission also, be allowed to means we are offering someone to do some task or to do something. Like, you can be on leave. Or we can also write, you can't be on leave. Okay. If it is for not granting, we write, you can't. And, or we can also write, you are allowed to. Can means allowed to. Can means allowed. Cannot means not allowed. Otherwise, you can also write, you are not allowed to be on leave. Okay. Understood. Even in making and granting request, if we want to request for something, we may use can, will, okay, could, may, together to may, to ask for permission or granting permission. Like, can I ask you a question? So here we are asking for a permission. Could I speak to Rahim? So same thing. So can I speak to Rahim? Also we can write. Could I ask you a question? Also we can write. May I ask you a question? Also we can write. May I use your car for a day? Also we can write. Can I use your car for a day? Also we can write. So we can take any of these modal auxiliaries, can, could, may, or in some time will also. Like, will you take me your home, like asking for permission. In making or granting offers that you need to help someone, if you want to help someone, then also you ask for giving help from your side by the use of these auxiliary verbs. Okay, like, I will help you with the sum. So here, by using will, modal auxiliary will, we are offering our help. Like, shall I help you? Or will I help you? Can I help you? Could I help you? Would you like? So here, would also we can use for granting offer or for making offer. Even for making and taking suggestion. Suggestion means advice. Also we can use shall, okay, could, to give suggestion or take suggestion also. Like, shall we go to Patna this autumn? So here we are asking for the suggestion. Okay. Why don't we go to Paris this autumn? Okay, so don't we. How about going to Paris this autumn? We could go to Paris this autumn. So here, by using shall and could, we have asked for suggestion or making suggestion or taking suggestion. Even for expressing restriction, if we want to express restriction, restriction means that something is not permitted to perform or not permit, that we have no permission to do such kind of act, that is restriction. So in expressing our restriction also, we can use restriction. If you are not giving permission, that means we have to add not with the modal auxiliaries, and we have to make the contraction of modal auxiliaries with this not, and we have to express our restriction. Like, you mustn't go near fire. That means there is restriction to go near fire. We can't go in such shabby clothes. That means we cannot go. There is a restriction to go with shabby clothes. Shabby means dirty or poor clothes. Okay, you aren't allowed to. See, allowed to. So that means expressing restriction, that something which is not permitted to do. Also, we use these modal auxiliaries for this expression. See, for giving advice or to express criticism. Express criticism means something you did not like or you do not like about something or someone. So here we use should, ought to, had better to give advice to somebody. So these are the modal auxiliaries to give advice to somebody. Like you ought to. You ought to means you have to see a doctor immediately. Ought to can be also used as have to also. Ought to means have to. That means in place of ought to, we can write have to also. You have to see your doctor immediately. Or you should see your doctor immediately. You had better see your doctor. So here, these three or four auxiliary verbs can be used to express criticism or advice. So expressing possibility. Possibility means something that is possible to take place, or some action that is possible to take place. If this kind of action which are possible to take place, we may make the use of could, may or might. Okay, or if you want to say that is not possible, impossible, that is also expressed by using the contraction, by using the negative form of may, that is may not, or might, negative form of might not, or negative form of could not. Could not can be used as a contraction, couldn't. Okay, like if it is possible, okay, she could be in the playground. Possibility that she could be in the playground. Savannah is not on her seat, she could be in the playground. There is the possibility of being Savannah in the playground. Like Smita may not go to school tomorrow. This is possibility that there is no possibility of Smita to go to school tomorrow. Okay, Smita couldn't go to school tomorrow. That means Smita may be unable to go to school tomorrow. So these are the action which are not possible to take place. Okay, it is not sure, but possibility is there. So if possibility and if there is no possible or no possibility of any action, then also we may use these modal auxiliaries and the negative form of these modal auxiliaries. If there is possibility, we use these modal auxiliaries. If there are no possibilities, then we may use the contraction form or by adding not after these modal auxiliaries. And also to express probability. Probability is also possibility that something which may take place in future. Okay, like to express something that may take place in future, we use ought to. We use ought to refer something that is possible or probable in the present or the future tense, future time. Mostly at present time, if something is something has possibility to take place, some action has possibility to take place, then we use ought to, that are possible to take place in present or future. Like Shraddha ought to be at cinema by now. By this time, it is possible that Shraddha may be at the cinema by now. We can also write in place of ought to, maybe. Shraddha may be at the cinema by now. Okay. We use should, ought to, have plus past participle to refer the something that was possible or was expected to take place in the past. So if, we can also we can also express probability in the past by using have plus b3, have plus b3 after should or ought to, like the flight ought to have landed on an hour ago. That means it is possibility that flight has already landed, but it is possibility that it has been landed before an hour. Okay, so it is the possibility of the action in the past. Okay, or it is expected this action to be or to have been taken place in the past. Okay, so the possibility in present and past, or the possibility in the present or past, we can express by using these modal auxiliaries. I hope you have understood. If you have not understood, then you may ask me the question. Okay, students.